Hello and welcome. Thank you so much for watching. This show is all about giving you insights and showcasing brands that help you to live your best life and give you confidence. As always, I want to kickstart your morning with some motivational advice to help you to feel inspired and energized to start your day. Today, I want to talk about the importance of believing in yourself and your dreams. The truth is, on the path to success, not everyone will support you. There might even be only a small handful of people who believe in your dreams when you first begin. Many people let that lack of support stop them from achieving their dreams because they get discouraged. In the beginning of your journey in achieving your goals, only you will be able to see the magnitude of your dreams. With each step forward, by taking action, you will get the confidence to believe in yourself fully and wholeheartedly when you witness small victories along the way. Only those who can see the invisible can achieve the impossible. The truth is, until you believe in yourself, no amount of external support can motivate you. You must first motivate and bet on yourself. The most successful people in the world, whether it be Bill Gates or Oprah Winfrey, are self-motivated. They believed in their skills and brand before the outside world could. There is no one in this world that lacks talent. We all have our own unique abilities and talents that we can offer the world. Remember, as Roy Bennett quotes, "Don't let others tell you what you can't do. Don't let the limitations of others limit your vision. If you can remove your self-doubt and believe in yourself, you can achieve what you never thought possible."
Stay tuned. Coming up after the break,
who are receiving these packages right now?
The majority of the stuff that we got were actually government agencies that reached out to us and said, "We have a women's abuse shelter that have no food."
What does luxury mean to you?
Luxury. In India, I discovered that true luxury isn't something you buy off a shelf. True luxury is a feeling that you are the Maharani of your world. And it can be all designed around you. All the beauty is yours. All the music is yours. India showed me that luxury doesn't follow designers and brands. True luxury follows its own heart.
Incredible India.
Next up on the show, I want to put the spotlight on a good Samaritan named Mitch Christantos, who has been giving back to the community during this COVID-19 crisis by helping those in need through various charity organizations. Mitch, thank you so much for being on the show today. You've been very busy, I see.
Yeah, the past 3 months have been pretty much nonstop, that's for sure.
I know, I've been seeing on your social media. Let's talk about the various organizations and charities that you've been involved with the past couple of months.
When this whole pandemic started, I posted something on my social media. Any restaurant owners or venues that are closing down and you have extra food, rather than throwing it away, let's repurpose it. And so I had a lot of calls come in from various venues. A good friend of mine, Jagger Gordon, who's got an amazing organization, called me up and said, "If you have the food, I'll take it." And we had hotels, venues, restaurants donate food to us. It was around that time that another friend of mine out of Ottawa, Abbas, who started a foundation called Operation Ramzia, called me up and said, "Mitch, I have this thing going in Ottawa. We're feeding people. We need to bring it to Toronto. Do you want to do it with us?" Mm-hmm. And I didn't hesitate. I said, "For sure." Initially, I thought it was going to be maybe feeding a couple hundred people 1 or 2 days a week. And this thing grew to the point where we were feeding 500 to 1,000 people a day. It started off with Abbas, myself, Mark Holmes from Platinum Blonde, and another friend of ours, Jeremy Stewart. And the thing just grew to the point where we have dozens of volunteers. We have a logistics company that was delivering the packages to people's homes, and the need is still there. If we were able to feed 5,000 people a day, we would. We just didn't have enough food to do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and let's talk about who are receiving these packages, because we were chatting earlier and you were saying you were shocked how many people need food. Let's talk about that and who are receiving these packages right now.
So we had an online setup where people can go online and register for food hampers. The majority of the stuff that we got were actually government agencies that reached out to us and said, we have a women's abuse shelter that have no food. We have a seniors residence that haven't eaten in 2 days. Can you please get them food? Mm-hmm. So that's kind of where a lot of the food that we were sending it was to these different, institutions. The need is there. Low-income families, people with disabilities, mental health patients, women abuse shelters. You know, the problem that we see right now is there are a lot of organizations out there that are helping, but they demand or their structure is set up where you have to go out and pick up the food. Mm-hmm. If you're in a women's abuse shelter and you're fearing for your life, how are you going to get onto a TTC bus to go down to a shelter or go down to a food bank to pick up your food? You're scared. Mm-hmm. If you're and you're in a wheelchair, how do you get onto a TTC bus, go down to a unit or a food bank and pick up your food? So we were delivering it directly to people's homes, which was phenomenal. Mm-hmm. We put our risk, there's no question about that. But I looked at the options, it was just, I couldn't say no. When I see someone suffering, it tugs at my heart no matter what. And I just said, I'm here.
I know, that was actually leading to my next question. I was gonna say, like, what made you put yourself at risk? Because being out there, especially during quarantine, especially with all the restrictions and being around people, I'm surprised that you did that. So what propelled you to, you know, really put yourself out there and give no matter what?
You know, all our volunteers, we were careful. I mean, we have our masks and we have our sanitizers and our gloves. Mm-hmm. We tried to keep our 6 feet apart. The reality is there's still risk. I mean, when we're delivering it there was a couple of times we delivered 400 hampers to a residence, and the top three floors were all COVID. And so what we did is we had to leave the boxes on the sidewalk. They sent their volunteers in to grab it. But you know what? We are at risk. We are, you know, couriers are picking up stuff from us. We have food companies that are dropping off food, or I'm picking up food, or we are picking up food. There's always risk. Once again, I just said to myself, it's worth taking that chance. I know it's crazy, and my family hated me at the beginning for doing it. You know, I was sleeping on the couch, but they realized that there's no stopping what I was doing, and so they embraced it.
Mm-hmm, yeah, that's amazing. You know, for the people that don't know, we did have actually Abyss from Operation Ramsay here on the show. But you know, for those people that don't know, that maybe need food or are in a tough situation right now, let's talk about a little bit about each organization. So Feed It Forward as well as Operation Ramsay.
Sure. So Feed It Forward, I'm sure if you haven't had Jagger on your show before, you have to. He's phenomenal. I mean, he's a chef by trade. And what he does is he repurposes the food. He cooks it, sometimes freezes it, and sends it out. But he also has a storefront set up as well. And where it was called Pay It Forward, where people go in, they pay what they can, but he feeds and helps so many people. And mm-hmm. You know, it was an honor and privilege to work with Jagger on it. You know, there was certain food that we were getting donated that I couldn't use, and so I would continue sending it to him. Mm-hmm. But mm-hmm. I think he's 5,000-6,000 people a day he was feeding as well. Wow. So it was incredible. This city, honestly, despite of everything that happened, it was amazing to see how many people came out. Even with donations, we raised $108,000 on GoFundMe, another $35,000 or $40,000 in private donations, as well as about $150,000 in donated food. These are people, these are companies that actually had no business coming in, they had no revenue, yet they were still donating food to us. And people calling us and saying, Mitch, I'm gonna donate, I can only do $20. It was just incredible to see how many people came together to help organizations like us. And there's many out there similar to us. Mm-hmm. You know, we just need government funding. So I hate to say it, but you know, without government funding, we can't do any more than we are doing right now.
Mm-hmm. I agree. And you know what, after seeing all the work you were doing and having Abyss on the show, I immediately donated. So I want to tell our viewers, go and donate to these amazing organizations because they are helping people and people are in need during this time. Let's talk about the impact that you have seen with your volunteer work.
In terms of the food delivery hampers and stuff? It's incredible. I mean, when we go into a senior's residence and we knock on their door and we leave them in the hamper, we try to walk away and they open the door and they cry. Mm-hmm. You know, we've met seniors that happen in 2 days. How does that happen in a city like this, like Toronto? Mm-hmm. You know, so it's a very humbling experience. And with our volunteers, we had volunteers that strictly only worked in the warehouse. We encouraged them to come out on the road with us one day for delivery. And it really puts things into perspective. We all complain about crazy things, you know, new car, you know, you ordered some product online, some clothes, and it came in the wrong size, and we get all upset about that. But at the end of the day, it's all irrelevant. I mean, we have, you know, food on our table, we have a roof over our heads. There are so many people out there that would die to have our life. They can't even buy a bottle of milk or a glass of milk for the kid. Mm-hmm. And that's sad.
Yeah.
And the longer this goes on, the more people are going to come out and say, you know, need help.
Mm-hmm. I agree. You know, I always see you at all of the charity organizations on the red carpets, but you're someone that really gives back. And that's why I really wanted to have you on the show, because you're someone who really walks the walk. So let's talk about the importance of giving back, and how would you encourage our viewers to do the same?
You know what? Listen, the way I look at it is, the best feeling in the world is to do something for others for no other reason than because. You know, when I'm just in my 50s now, 51, but when I was in my late 20s, I actually volunteered at SickKids on the oncology unit for 18 years. And so every Friday, I would take the afternoon off work and I would go into the oncology unit. And, you know, I did that until my mid-30s, late-30s, early-40s. And it was a very humbling experience as well when we see these kids going through what they're going through. And it got to a point where I just can't say no to different charities. So I get asked all the time to be a part of it, various charities. And I love it. From the Fight to End Cancer, where I stepped in the ring 4 years ago for a 3-round sanctioned boxing match to raise money for Princess Margaret Cancer Foundation. Mm-hmm. So, you know, once you start doing it, you get addicted to it. It's a high. When you that you're doing things for others. Look, I would love to get to a point where I don't have to work anymore and I can do that full time. My goal in life, I made a career change a few years ago for that purpose, was I wanted to do something where not only did it give me more time to donate my time, but to the point where I can do it full time if possible, because I just love it. It's just such a great feeling doing it for others.
I agree. And that's the most important thing, really, is to give back. And there's no better feeling than giving back, knowing you're inspiring people, knowing you're helping people. I think that's really great. You know, you've seen a lot, as you've been saying, this past couple of months have been crazy for you. And you described it as a bit of hell as well. What have you learned from this whole experience, this quarantine, from everything you've been doing? What have you learned from everything so far?
You know, I live every day like it's your last. You know, so many times we set goals and we kind of procrastinate, you know. For the longest time, I said I wanted to get a new car, and I kept on saying not the right time, maybe next year, next month. Just do it, because you know what? One day you may wake up and realize that that is your last day. The vacation you've always wanted. You know, so many people say, you know, I want to start a family, but maybe it's not the right time. Well, when is the right time? You know, do it now, because you don't know what the future holds. And just enjoy life. Treat everyone with respect. And be happy.
Mm-hmm. I think that's great advice and so true. Where can people connect with you on social media?
Instagram, Mitch_Cristantos. There you have it, KrystantoS.
Okay.
And Facebook, Mitch Cristantos.
Amazing. Well, keep up the amazing work that you're doing and keep inspiring. Thank you so much for being on the show.
No problem. But one last thing. I heard it's your birthday today, and I was wondering if I can sing you a quick happy birthday.
It is my birthday. I know, right? Sure. I welcome it. Sure.
You don't want to hear my voice. Happy birthday. And I'm so proud of what you've done. I've seen you over the years grow, and you are such an inspiration to so many women out there. And I know my daughters look up to you, and I know there are many others. So continue doing what you're doing. If I can do anything to help you with your brand and get your name out there, I will, because there's such a need for strong, powerful women today.
Oh, thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Thank you. Keep in touch. Thanks.
Okay, bye. Tag TV is available on Roku, Amazon Fire TV, Apple and Android TVs, as well as on Apple and Android phones. Watch us live through YouTube and Facebook.